Hello people, my name is Ferdy and in this video I will show you how you can migrate your WordPress website to a different domain for free. Even if it's a website that's 1 gigabyte or 10 or even up to 100 gigabyte, I will show you how it is done using a free tool. And if you like this video, please like it. Feel free to subscribe for more upcoming WordPress related tutorials. Now, let's get started. So here I have my biggest website. It's around 1 gigabyte, but I uploaded a lot of videos. So the website is 12 gigabyte and I'll show you in this video how you can transfer this website to a different domain or as a backup completely for free. So I go to the backend and I hover over plugins, add new. I'm going to install a plugin called All-in-One WP Migration. So I search over here, All-in-One WP Migration. Really simple name for a plugin. And over here, I click on install now. And you see a lot of installations, a lot of nice reviews. And then I click on activate. And with this plugin, I can export my complete 12 gigabyte website completely for free. So I go to All-in-One WP Migration and I click on export. And then I click over here on file. That's it. It will prepare. And since I have a really big website, I can take a while. So I will fast forward, but normally my websites are around 200 megabytes. So it's exported within a few seconds. So there it is. Download ferdykorpershoek.com, 12 gigabytes. So I click on download and it can take a while before it's downloaded. 16 seconds. Wow. And now I go to my new website, ferdykorpershoek.com. And what I have over here is a brand new website. And I want to import my website ferdykorpershoek to ferdykorpershoek2.com, my 12 gigabyte website. So the first thing I want to do when I use a brand new installation and I want to import a backup or migrate a website, I go to posts. I remove all the posts to the trash and I empty the trash. I go to pages, select all the pages, move them to the trash, apply it. Then I go to the trash and I empty the trash. Also, if you have media, select everything using bulk select, click on the first one, hold shift, click on the latest one, and then delete. And then I go to appearance themes, and I want to remove all the themes that are not active. So I have a clean installation of WordPress, because otherwise my posts can stay intact, and then I have posts in my migrated website. I don't want that. Now, if I would go to plugins, add new, and I would search for All-in-One WP Migration, look what happens. I click on install now. I click on activate. And I go to All-in-One WP Migration and I click on import. And then I see I'm limited with 300 megabytes, but this website is 12 gigabyte. How can I do this? Well, there's something called GPL version 3 license. And that means that when you download a file or you buy something that has that license, you can adjust it. So a friend of mine did that, WP Press Doctor. He created a file from All-in-One WP Migration that can let you migrate a website that is 100 gigabytes. So why can the WordPress Doctor change this file? Well, because this file, this plugin falls under the GPL version 3 license, which gives people the right to adjust the source code. So that's what he has done. Nothing illegal here. So we're good to go. So I go to plugins, I deactivate this one and I delete it. And let me show you how it is done. In the new tab, I go to ferdykorp.com/migrate. You will be redirected to the Google Drive of WP Press Doctor. And then you click on download on this icon. There it goes. I close this. Now I go to plugins, add new, upload plugin. And I drag this one from WordPress Doctor up to 100 gigabytes and I click on install now. And then it will say to you when you activate it, that is not the final version, the most updated version, but that's okay. Because if you update it, you are limited to 300 megabytes again. Keep in mind that when you have used this tool, you've migrated your website, that you remove the tool from your website. So now if I go to All-in-One WP Migration and I click on import, I have up to 100 gigabytes, depending on how much room you have on your server. If you still see it's limited, you can go to your web hosting provider and make sure it is increased by going to the chat or going to certain settings. So over here, I have my 12 gigabyte website. Let me check it one more time. Yes, 13 gigabytes. I drag it over here. I think I can take a break. Okay, now I click on proceed. So our data has been successfully imported and it says subscribe to the WordPress Doctor channel. So I would do that if I were you. This guy gives a lot of tutorials, especially about Divi. So I highly suggest you do that. Now we need to go to the permalink settings. So I go to settings, permalinks, and keep in mind that you need to log in again with the details that you have over here. Because this is now an exact clone of this website. So save it on postname twice, save the changes. And save the changes, otherwise you can get problems in your website. I close this and now this is my current website, my migrated website. So the regular one with this sub menu, mega menu. And now if I go to the homepage over here, it should be exactly the same. Okay, I go to Elementor tutorial. It looks like this. I go to Elementor tutorial. And it looks like this, exactly the same. And since I entered the website over here for the first time, I can accept this. So resources. They both look the same. I have an exact copy of 12 gigabytes migrated for free. And why is my website so big? I said it before. I go to media. I uploaded a lot of videos to make it as heavy as it is, and I will delete them right now. But that's how you can copy and paste or migrate a complete website for free. You can also use this tool as a backup tool. So now and then you can make a backup of your website. Then when something goes wrong, you can put it back. And I think this is the best and simplest way to make these backups. There are also web hosting providers that will make a backup for your website every day. I highly suggest you get a web hosting provider that like that. But if you want to make a website on your computer, I have a tutorial about that, and you want to put it on a live domain when you're ready, you can do that. So if you search for local WP Ferdy, I show you how to get you make a website on your own computer. And then through these principles I show you in this tutorial, you know how to export them to your live website. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you liked it and I hope you're able to migrate your big website or make a backup with it. And I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please like it and feel free to leave a comment to say that you like it, or if you have any question, let me know in the comments. I'll do my best to answer them. And then I hope you have a great day and feel free to subscribe to this YouTube channel for more upcoming WordPress related tutorials. And I want to show you something. Normally I'm carrying my blue t-shirt. Rest assured, I still have my blue t-shirt. But this time it has no V because I also have different t-shirts without a V. This t-shirt, I don't know how it's called, but the one with the V is called Barcelona. Barcelona is playing right now on the iPad, but I cannot watch it because I'm watching myself. Because then I can see if everything is in focus. Well, I think it is. So I can turn this off and then I can continue to watch the game or edit the video or do it at the same time. Okay. Bye-bye.